This is Alfred,
the comedian who won the award for the funniest joke at Edinburgh Fringe 2019, will return to headline at Shaftesbury Fringe in July. Swedish stand-up Olav Falafel has been recognised for his comedy material for 3 years in a row. Olav was one of the first performers to register for Shaftesbury Fringe 2020 when the website started accepting bookings on the 1st of January. As he waited to board a plane at Copenhagen Airport, he shared his gag voted the best at last year's Edinburgh Fringe.
I keep randomly shouting out cauliflower and broccoli. I think I might have florets.
Each year, television channel Dave asks 10 critics to compile their shortlist of their 6 favourite jokes from the Edinburgh events. Those choices are then shared with 2,000 people who are not told the name of the performers. They vote for their favourite. Olav says the publicity that followed his win led to sell-out shows.
It was doing quite well anyway, and then all of a sudden, overnight, I was having to turn people away. So yeah, it was really good.
It's been good for business.
It was definitely good for business.
Somebody once said there's no such thing as bad publicity, and it seems that the media that reported outrage over the joke helped to keep Olav in the spotlight for even longer. There were claims that the gag was mocking Tourette sufferers. Olav doesn't agree. Nevertheless, the reaction surprised the comedian, and he received some direct complaints.
I got quite a bit, actually, on pretty much every social media channel, including email, people being quite vocal, asking me to publicly apologise for it, saying it was offensive, and which was interesting. I must admit, I was number 3 in that list last year, and then 2 years ago I was number 9. And the one 2 years ago I thought was far more, I wouldn't say offensive because I don't think any of them are offensive, but far more likely to incur outrage. The one that a couple of years ago was, I wasn't that close to my dad before he died, which was lucky because he trod on a landmine.
I can see why people might react to that more.
No one at all. Whereas this one, yeah, there was like a huge outcry from the kind of Tourette's syndrome community. A lot of it was people who wanted to create awareness about Tourette's, which they clearly did, and kind of rode on the back of it. I think some people were genuinely offended by it, which I can't quite understand, but it was wordplay. It was never mocking people, and it wasn't done from a place of hatred. I don't think a joke necessarily has to have a target or a butt of a joke, and I don't think I was aiming to say anything negative towards people with Tourette's syndrome. It was merely the word Tourette sounds a bit like florets. I do try and think about things before I say them, like all comedians tend to, or most comedians tend to. It just depends where that line is, and everybody has that line in their head, and it's different for everyone, so you're never going to please everybody.
Were you surprised by the reaction?
A little, yeah. Somewhat. Like, for example, the one last year that came third was, I just took out a loan to pay for an exorcism. If I don't pay it back, I'm getting repossessed.
That's very good.
There are people out there who have taken out loans and had their homes repossessed. I'm sure they could find offence at that if you want to dig deep enough. So it's one of those things, isn't it? You can look into any subject, and I'm sure there is somebody in the world who could be triggered.
Now, with you being so successful as having your jokes listed as some of the funniest at the Edinburgh Fringe, and of course last year the funniest, does that put loads of pressure on you with trying to maintain your crown for 2020 in Shaftesbury and at the Edinburgh Fringe?
No, I don't think. I think the pressure's off, to be honest. I've kind of been in that list 3 times in a row. I'm fully expecting not to feature at all this year.
He says he enjoyed his performance at Shaftesbury Fringe and is looking forward to returning with a new hour-long set this summer.
I remember it last year. It was a wonderful, wonderful show. Great audience. They all got on board. And yeah, really good fun. It's a really good warm-up for Edinburgh. So yeah, hoping for more of the same.
Because we are a small town, obviously, compared to Edinburgh or some of the other fringe venues. Why does it work for you as a comedian coming to a titchy little place like Shaftesbury?
It works on a number of fronts. Firstly, you need comedians need to kind of run through their stuff. And if you're doing an Edinburgh show, a lot of it's experimental, and it's the kind of stuff that you can't necessarily do in a 15-minute set at a London comedy club. So it's the sort of thing where you need someone that's a little bit more off the beaten track that's willing to give you an hour, but perhaps you don't have as much comedy come to you, so perhaps you're a bit more appreciative when people do come along, and perhaps a bit more forgiving when it's a bit more stupid and perhaps not quite as polished. Really good, really enjoyed it, and hence why I'm back.
Olav's hour-long show, Perkin Wogress, is on at the back room of the Mitre at 8:45pm on Saturday the 7th of July. If you want to present your own comedy, music, theatre or spoken word show in one of the many venues dotted around Shaftesbury Town Centre, registration is now open for Shaftesbury Fringe at shaftesburyfringe.co.uk.
Listen to Alfred.